Mr. Excel Podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast versus floating bracket. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jellin. Today, a cool idea sent in by Dave from one of the South Florida fire departments down there. Dave is a frequent contributor to the Mr. Excel Netcast. And so Dave is keeping track of statistics for all the firefighters on the force and large fire department. I don't know actually how many people he has. I created a data set here with 200 and some firefighters. And for each firefighter, they do an annual physical exam where they see how many push-ups they can do. All right. And so then Dave has all of the firefighters, their age, and the number of push-ups, and they want to see how they do compared to the average. But there's 20-year-old guys in the force, and there's 55-year-old guys in the force, and it's not fair to compare the 55-year-old to the 20-year-old. And so Dave came up with a clever method. He even said, you know, even if you compare based on decade, all right, if you take a 41-year-old and a 49-year-old, you just can't. You can't compare those. It's not a fair comparison. So he used one of the new functions in Excel 2007. I thought this was really cool. He used AVERAGEIFS, and what he did is he built a bracket that if this person is 20, they're compared to everyone who's 18, 19, 20, 21, or 22. This person who's 49, they're compared to everyone who is 47 through 51. All right, so it's comparing, you know, yes, I think the average, let's see, what's the average of everybody? The average of everybody is 35 push-ups, but you take this person who's 49 and you compare them to the average of everybody, you'd be doing horribly. Comparing them to the average of everyone who's 47 to 51, he's still 20% under the average, but he's not, you know, 75% below the average. All right, so let's take a look at this formula. I thought it was pretty cool. I used evaluate formula to take a look at it. And the first thing it does is it takes his current age in B2 and subtracts this constant from it. So B2 minus G2, let's evaluate. B2 is 20, G2 is 2, and so we now have built on the fly a criteria of greater than or equal to 18, and see that actually evaluates the text. All right, so we're looking at all of the push-ups in C2 to C269, and we're going to average them if it matches the criteria where the age is greater than or equal to 18. All right, I'll evaluate again. So now we have B2, that's 20 plus 2, and is less than or equal to 22. So right at this point, it's going to take an average of all the people who are 18 through 22, and that'll be the average by which this firefighter is compared. All right, but if we go down to someone else, let's find someone older here, so someone who's 57. When we evaluate the formula for him, we're looking at everyone greater than or equal to 55, less than or equal to 59. All right, so it actually creates a dynamic floating bracket looking at people 2 years younger and 2 years older, all the way down, and seeing how you compare against that particular group. And so it's possible that someone who's 57 and someone who's 56 are going to have a different bracket average. And so even though they're kind of in the bracket together, they're this guy's being compared to someone who's 54, this guy's only being compared to someone who's 55. And so it creates an interesting set of statistics. I thought that was a cool idea. So shout out to Dave and everyone at his fire department for sending in this idea. Well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. See you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.